Rundag na kami na nagtatanong. Kaya nga ang sabi ng Vice President, narinig ko, I am already communicating. I am about to communicate with the COA. I think she will do that because that is the process. Hindi naman pwedeng hindi niya sagutin.
Colleague Marcoleta, I would like Madam Chair to remind our colleague, Mr. Marcoleta, Representative Marcoleta, that such terminology as nagtatatalon para magtanong is are improper. To insinuate that my colleagues and us, who validly and willingly want to pose valid questions regarding the budget of the Office of the Vice President, is unacceptable. Hindi po kami nagtatatalon. We have valid questions. I wanted to ask valid questions, but of course, nobody is here to answer them. Which brings me to my second point, that I was listening intently to the intervention of Representative Marcoleta about respect for tradition. And I agree that, yes, there are traditions, and courtesy is extended where courtesy is also given. And this no-show for me is not exactly what you would call a courteous gesture on the part of the Office of the Vice President. Nevertheless, Madam Chair, once more, I'd like to express my frustration that sinubukan ko lang po dumating today with certain valid questions, but wala pong tayong sasagot dito. Thank you very much, Madam Chair.
Salamat.
Questions to ask. But nonetheless, I'll be content with listening to the explanation perhaps of the Commission on Audit. Ang simple lang po yung tanong ko, kasi at the end of the day, yung Commission on Audit, Madam Chair, sila po yung nagdedetermine kung isang pondo ay nagastos ng mas maayos. But I wish to go back to the basics. Ano exactly from the point of view ng COA ang mandato ng opisina ng Vice President? Kasi at the end of the day, dito po sa mandato, mami-measure exactly kung yung mga pondo at ginagastos are aligned exactly with the mandate. So gusto kong maintindihan mula sa punto de vista ng Commission on Audit, ano po sa tingin po nila exactly ang mandato po ng Office of the Vice President? Maraming salamat po.
Madam Chair, as I mentioned earlier po, the mandate of the OBP is, one of the mandate of the OBP is committed to the service of the nation, which perform executive, ceremonial, and advocacy functions to improve the lives of the Filipino people. That's why some of social services were implemented, or programs for social services are proposed.
Maraming salamat po, Madam Chair. Follow-up question. So sa tingin po ninyo, yung mga proposal po ngayon, alay naman po doon sa mandato ng Office of the Vice President?
Based on the mandate of the Office of the Vice President, yes. Since the programs is considered social services, socio-economic services po, Madam Chair.
Maraming salamat po, Madam Chair.
Okay. So now we shall begin round two. And the chair now recognizes the Honorable Jill Bongalon.
Thank you, Madam Chair. Madam Chair, quick clarification with the Commission on Audit. Pwede ko ba malaman kung nagsumiti po ng liquidation report ang ating pong Vice Presidente patungkol po doon sa confidential funds?
What period po, Madam Chair?
2022.
Yes po, Madam Chair.
May I know when did the Office of the Vice President submit the liquidation report?
Madam Chair, the ICFA received the liquidation report on January 17, 2023.
May I know from the Commission on Audit if the submission was filed on time?
There is a slight issue on the provisions of the joint circular, because while the joint circular says that all liquidations must be all cash advances must be liquidated at year end, there's also a provision that allows the submission of the liquidation within 30 days from the end of the quarter, Madam Chair.
What is the answer to my question? Was it submitted on time?
So, as far as we have determined before, they have submitted it on time since it was within the 30-day.
All right. So, after the submission that you have mentioned, made sometime in January of 2023, is that the last submission of the liquidation report that the Office of the Vice President submit? Are there any other submissions made by the Office of the Vice President?
Madam Chair, they submitted an additional document.
When did the Office of the Vice President submit the additional document, for just for the record, Madam Chair? Is that in the nature of liquidation report also?
It was an accomplishment report, Madam Chair.
So what is the nature of that report?
It is an accomplishment report. It is part of the liquidation report, but not an entirely...
That is part of the liquidation report that was submitted sometime in January. May I know, just for the record, when did the Office of the Vice President submit the accomplishment report?
The initial submission was on January 17, and the submission on September 18 was an amendment to the accomplishment report.
So in other words, binigyan po ng pagkakataon ang opisina po ng ating Vice Presidente na magpaliwanag dito po sa kanyang liquidation report.
Since we have not yet issued an AOM at that point, actually it would have been one of the findings, but then they were able to submit the accomplishment report po,
so, Madam Chair. Sa madaling salita, Madam Chair, nagkaroon ng maraming pagkakataon ang opisina po ng Vice Presidente na magpaliwanag dito po sa kanyang liquidation report.
Yes, Madam Chair.
So, would that be amount to observance of due process on the part of the Commission on Audit?
I would think so, Madam Chair, since they have received our initial audit actions which have led to the issuance of the notice of disallowance, Madam Chair.
Would that be all?
Yeah, that would be all, Madam Chair.
Okay. The Honorable Zia Diong.
Thank you. Thank you very much. I just want to understand po, because I was following the exchanges and the questions of Congressman Jill Bungalon. So prior to issuing the disallowance, notice of disallowance, there was a process and steps that you require for the OVP to the office of the OVP to respond.
Yes,
to this observation. No, I just want to walk me through. No, how many processes does actually entail before COA finally decides to issue a notice of disallowance?
From the moment the agency submits their liquidation report, we do our audit on the liquidation based on the joint circular issued by the joint circular by DCOA, DBM, DILG, and GCG, and DND. Mm-hmm. And then if the liquidation is in order, we could just issue a credit notice. But if not, if there are deficiencies, we issue an audit observation memorandum advising them. The AOM, would then have to be replied to by the agency head within 15 days, and then if they comply with the AOM, again, if the AOM is sufficient, the liquidation is passed in audit. However, if we can still find deficiencies in the compliance, we usually issue the notice of suspension.
Mm-hmm. Again, and after the notice of suspension, there's another series of requests that you want for a specific agency to submit.